a baby, while letting the world know that you are single. Well, you may never get a date unless they're a big lonely baby too. If you think you've got it tough now, but you can't even cook, it may have been even more pitiful for you in 1974. In 1974, Gerber created a new product that was marketed to college students and adult singles who needed convenient single-serving meals. The foods included fruits, vegetables, starters, desserts, and you have it here, some beef burgundy, Mediterranean vegetables, and blueberry delight, all pureed in baby jars. Singles by Gerber, a line of single-serving dishes such as beef burgundy, sweet and sour pork. Babies never had it so good. Packed in those familiar Gerber glass jars, the theme line, we were good for you then, we're good for you now. Well, it may be true, but I don't think a single's life is looking too great right now. Gerber is trying to be practical by using the same jars for the adult singles as their baby foods. Groundbreaking? Not really. So, this afternoon, I'm going to tell you about the Gerber Singles failed innovation, but analyzing the background of this innovation and why it failed to diffuse, we can have a better understanding of this adult single serving nightmare. Well, at the time, I'm sure there's not as many options for the single adult trying to have a convenient meal for themselves. This doesn't mean a baby food enterprise should have the green light to create a jarred adult version of baby food, because it's basically the same thing. So, Gerber thought it was a great opportunity to target this niche market of single adults who needed a single meal. Furthermore, I've spent the last couple of weeks gathering information on this failed product and was interested in how a baby food enterprise could actually attempt to market nearly the same food to adults with the name Singles. So, let's talk about the background of this innovation. As I mentioned earlier, in 1974, Gerber launched the Gerber Singles, believing that the targeted niche market for single adults and students would bring profit. The jarred meals compared to other single-serving products in the market seemed to be less than that of an appealing meal. So it was a complete marketing failure, obviously. According to CNN's article, Funky Fries and Other Foods That Flopped, it didn't take long for Gerber execs to figure out that most consumers, unless they were a year old, couldn't get used to eating a pureed meal out of a jar, especially one depressingly labeled Singles. Singles. The idea was that any single adult, middle-aged person, or elderly, could eat their Singles alone, at home. It was clear that Gerber did not conduct any marketing research before releasing this embarrassing product. If they had done their research, perhaps it would have been a very successful single portion food and a better packaging for people on the go. In conclusion, I'm sure we have learned that making money seems like a great idea. But you have to do your market research first. So today, I took the time to tell you about the failed innovation of Gerber Singles. By exploring the background and why it failed to diffuse, we now have a better understanding. Although this innovation failed, Gerber remains a very successful enterprise. That is because they can only market baby food correctly. To quote Nathan Fielder, "I'm very bad at ending sentences. A lot of times I just want to say, that was the end of my sentence. I have nothing more to say." Well, that doesn't really make sense here, does it? Well, neither did the Gerber Singles. Thank you.